Hello everyone, this is Akang Suman here. Now we are going to solve the questions based on the dynamic analysis. So what is given in the question? In the question it is given that a vertical double acting steam engine. It is a vertical engine. Okay, it is not a horizontal engine. What is the difference between vertical and horizontal? If I'm talking about the piston effort, mg force will be included in this piston effort when the engine is vertical. Okay, so vertical double acting steam engine has a cylinder 300 mm diameter. This is the diameter of the cylinder, that means the diameter of the piston I can consider. So this is the 300 mm, but this is on the cover side. 450 mm stroke is given, but the radius of the crank is not given. So you can calculate the stroke is equal to 2 into radius of the crank. We all know that 2 into radius of the crank is intentions to give stroke is to find out the radius of the crank using this relation. Radius of the crank R. So from here we can get the value of R is equal to stroke by 2, and stroke is 450 mm. 450 mm by 2. So you'll get the value of radius, that is 225 mm. So I can write it in meter. So that would be R would be equal to 0.225 meter. This is the radius of the crank in meter. Okay, now reciprocating parts mass is given, that is 225 kilogram. The piston rod diameter, now this time the piston rod diameter is given, that means small d is given. I'm writing here small d is 50 mm. So from here we can calculate the area. Okay, so if this is a piston, understand this, if this is a piston and this is the cover side area of the piston and this is the crank side, we all know that on the crank side there is a piston rod is attached to the piston. Okay, and now this time it is having the diameter small d, and we all know that the capital D is the diameter of the piston on the cover side. So we can calculate A1 and A2. So from here I am just calculating A1 is equal to pi by 4 d square, that means pi by 4, and d value is given 0.3 meter square, and you will get the value of area A1 square 0.07. it would comes out to be 0.07 mm square. Okay, similarly you can calculate the area A2 on the crank side, pi by 4 d square minus d square. Okay, because on the crank side you can see there is the capital D and there is a small d diameter having piston rod. So pi by 4 0.3 square minus 0.05 square. From here when you solve this you will get the value of A2. So we'll get the value of A2, that would be 0.068 meter square. This is in meter, sorry, I made a mistake here. This is in meter because we have put the diameter value in meter, so it would be in meter square, or this is meter square. Okay, so we have calculated area A1 and area A2. Okay, now what is given in the question? The connecting rod length is given 1.2. So here L is equal to 1.2 is given, 1.2 meter. So from here we can calculate the obliquity ratio, N is equal to L upon R. And what is L? That is 1.2 and R is 0.225. So from here you can get the value of obligatory ratios, that is 1.2 divided by 0.225, and it would comes out to be 5.33. Okay, so it is n is equal to 5.33. Okay, now when the crank has turned through 125 degree, the theta value is given. The theta is given, that is 125 degree. This is a conventional type question. Every concept you can clear in this question. 125 degree from the top dead center. Theta is measured from top dead center. Okay, what is top dead center? This is top dead center. Okay, so theta is like that. Okay, however, I am just drawing the rough diagram. Okay, so if you draw the 125 degree from the top dead center, it would be here, like here, somewhere here. Okay. This is a rough diagram actually. So this would be the 125 degree. The piston would be here. The crank should be here. The steam pressure above the piston is 30 kN per meter and below the piston is 1.5. So here the piston P1 is given. Okay, and P2 is also given. So here F gas pressure you can calculate. So in the next page I am calculating the F gas force, that is P1 A1 minus P2 A2. What is P1? That is 30 kN per meter square, and below the piston the pressure is 1.5 kN per meter square. Okay, so multiply A1. A1 is also in meter, so that is 0.07 minus 1.5. What is A2? A2 is 0.068 in meter square. Unit must be same. Okay, if you are considering the piston pressure, you are considering the pressure in newton per kilonewton per mm square, you must have to be put the value of cross sectional area in mm square. But here in the question the data of the pressure is given kilonewton per meter square, so we must have to put the area in meter square. Okay, so they will be cancelled out and we can get the value of gas pressure in kilonewton. So when you solve this, you will get the value. So this is 2.1 minus, I am just using calculator, you should have to use the calculator also. So that is 0.102, and when you subtract this, you will get the value of F gas. Okay, and that would comes out to be approximately, I'm writing here, approximately 2 kilonewton. Approximately it would be 2 kilonewton. This is a gas pressure and we must have to calculate the inertia force also. What is m into a? This is the, what is the inertia force? M into acceleration. Why I am calculating the inertia forces? Because we must have to use the piston effort. We must have to calculate the piston effort. In the piston effort formula, you know that there is a gas forces and there is a inertia forces also considered. Okay, since it is vertical engine, we must have to convert mg force also in the piston effort formula. So what is the piston effort formula? I am writing here so that you can understand. So this is the piston effort F. This is F gas minus F inertia. And mg is vertically downward, so I'm taking plus sign, not plus sign just because mg is in downward. I'm considering plus sign because here the piston effort is also in downward action and mg is also in downward action, so that's why I'm considering plus sign here. Okay, mg always working in the downward actions, but when you take the plus sign and when you take the minus sign, it depends on the type of vertical engine. Since here you can see that this is a gas pressure. This is a gas pressure which is working in the downward actions. So that's why I'm considering here mg plus sign. Okay. So ma, what is the acceleration formula? That is mr ओमेगा स्क्वायर कोस थीटा प्लस, फर्स्ट यू हैव टू राइट द फॉर्मूला अगेन एंड अगेन सो दैट यू विल बी एबल टू रिमेंबर इन द एग्जामिनेशंस विद नो एरर विद नो कन्फ्यूजन्स. व्हाट इज द मास? मास इज गिवन, दैट इज 225 किलोग्राम मल्टीप्लाई आर. रेडियस वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड, दैट इज 225 mm, दैट इज 0.225 मीटर, 0.225 मीटर. एंड व्हाट इज ओमेगा? ओमेगा वी हैव नॉट कैलकुलेटेड, आई थिंक ओमेगा इज नॉट बीइंग कैलकुलेटेड, बट द स्पीड इज गिवन, कैपिटल एन स्पीड ऑफ द इंजन इज गिवन, दैट इज 200 आरपीएम. यू कैन कैलकुलेट द ओमेगा वैल्यू हियर डायरेक्टली. सो 2 पाई 200 अपॉन 60. सो व्हेन यू सॉल्व दिस यू विल गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ ओमेगा. And it would comes out to be 20.94 radian per second. 20.94 radian per second. Okay. So here cos theta. Theta value is given, that is 125. Plus cos 2 theta means 125 multiply 2. And you will get cos 250. Cos 250 upon n. N value we have calculated, that would be 5.33. You just have to calculate these equations and you will get the value of inertia forces. So it would comes out to be minus 14.14172 newton. But it is in Newton, we must have to convert it in kilonewton by dividing by 1000. So it would be minus 14.17 kilonewton. Okay, this minus sign is comes out just because of cos 125 degree, because cos theta is negative in the second quadrant. Okay, now you just have to use the FI, that means the inertia forces with the sign. Okay, don't ignore the sign. So here we are just using the piston effort formula. So F is equal to F gas. F gas is 2 kN minus Fi. Fi value is minus 14.17. The force is in kN here plus mg. What is the mass as 225? 225, if g is not given, you can assume 10 upon 1000 just because to convert it into kilonewton. Okay, so finally when you solve this you will get the piston effort, and the piston effort that we will get here, and that would comes out to be 18.42 kilonewton. Okay, now see here in the question what is being asked, that effective turning moment we have to calculate. First we need to know what is the formula of the turning moment. Here T is equal to Ft into R. What is Ft? Either it is tangential forces on the crank, or sometimes it is called as the crank effort. Okay, so this is the turning moment. This is what we have to calculate, turning moment. So first we need to calculate Ft. We know that tangential force is equal to Fc sine theta plus beta. And what is Fc? We must have to convert it into piston effort. Fc is equal to F upon cos of beta multiply sine theta plus beta. Okay, so what is the value of piston effort? We have calculated already 18.42 upon cos beta. We have not calculated the value of beta, so first we need to calculate the value of beta. We know that L sine beta is equal to R cos R sine theta. From here you can calculate the value of beta, that is sin beta is equal to sin theta upon n. Okay, so I'm just calculating here the value of beta using calculator, because theta is 125 and n is 5.33. So from here you can calculate the value of beta, that would comes out to be 8.84 degree. If you are not able to look it here, I'm just writing here beta is equal to 8.84 degree. Okay, this is the value of beta. So beta is 8.84 here. 8.84 multiply sin theta plus beta. Theta is 125 plus 8.84. So when you solve this, you will get the value of tangential forces or the crank effort. So tangential force comes out to be 13.44 kilonewton. Now we can get the value of turning moment, that is 13.44 multiply 0.225, and when you multiply with 0.225, you will get the value 3.02 kilonewton into meter. So that is the final answer for the turning moment. I hope you will able to understand how to solve this question. Okay, this is nothing new. We just have to put the value of piston effort and number of forces in the piston effort we have to calculate separately. F gas, then F inertia. Remember this, F, this is the general equations. If F inertia you have to put with the sign. Okay, in the question there is a minus sign along with the inertia forces. You just have to put the value of inertia forces along with sign. Okay, here you can see. Okay, so everything is clear. So thank you.